Okay. Ladies. Ek weet nie of al gents is nie, maar ek dink ons is net ladies. Okay, hier gaat ons. So, bachata is a Latin dance. Latin dance word gewoonlik met 'n partner gedans, maar jy kan dit ook solo doen en dis presies wat ons vanaand gaan doen. So op die liedjie wat ek vir julle gestuur het, is daar 'n spesifieke routine wat ek uitgewerk het. Maar ons gaan nie vanaand al begin worry oor die routine nie. Ek gaan net vanaand vir julle die klomp verskillende basic steps van bachata leer. Laat julle dit kan inoefen, want as jy dit inoefen in die verskillende rigtings wat mense dit kan doen, daarna is dit baie makliker om dan 'n routine te leer, eerder as wat jy van scratch af onmiddellik 'n routine moet begin kop. Okay. So, ek gaan my rug na julle toe draai. Want ek wil hê julle moet om presies in dieselfde rigting leer as wat ek het doen. So, julle gaan met julle regterbeen begin vir nou, want ons is mos nou eintlik ladies. Ladies begin altyd met hulle regterbeen as jy Latin dancing doen. Dan gaan jy kant toe gaan vir 3 steps. 1, 2, 3 en dan tap jy net jou voet daar. En dan gaan ons links gaan. 1, 2, 3, tap. En dit noem ons die side to side basic van die cha-cha. Ach, bachata, askies. So, ons loop. Side and tap, side and tap. Nou moet jy jou heupe begin bysit. En tap, so die oomblik as jy tap, dan skrik jou heup en hy spring op. En up met die heup. En up met die heup. Hip, 1, 2, 3 en hip, 1, 2, 3 en hip. Okay, maak dit vir julle sin, is julle met my? Gee my some kind of indication dat julle lewendig is. Hierdie is 'n baie meer interactive klas as die ander. Is julle met my? Gee my sommer 'n thumbs up of iets. Okay, so julle is by. Okay, so dit is die side to side basic. As mens lady is, begin mens regs. 1, 2, 3, hip. 1, 2, 3, hip. As mens gent is, dan begin jy net eenvoudig links, maar jou step lyk presies dieselfde. 1, 2, 3, up with the hip, en tap. Dan kry jy ook jou forward, backward, of jou progressive basic. In plaas daarvan dat jy kant toe beweeg, gaan jy net eenvoudig vorentoe en agtertoe beweeg. So kom ons gaan eers as lady, gaan ons vorentoe. 1, 2, 3, dan tap jy met die voet daar agter waar hy is, en hy is die voet wat dan weer agtertoe beweeg. 1, 2, 3, tap, dan bly die voet daarvoor. So toe ons kant toe beweeg het, sou julle gesien het, ons gaan 1, 2, 3, en jy tap met die voet net daar, dis nie dat jy noodwendig toemaak nie. En as ons dan weer kant toe gaan, 1, 2, 3, tap. So jy hou kind of die hele tyd so effens 'n gap tussen jou bene. So as ons vorentoe gaan, is dit dieselfde konsep. 1, 2, 3, dan los jy die been daar en tap en onthou die heup en dan gaan jy agtertoe. 1, 2, 3, hip. Ek gaan net dwars draai, dat julle kan sien hoe lyk dit. 1, 2, 3, hip. 1, 2, 3, hip. Okay, as ons gent is, lyk die step precies dieselfde. Jy gaan net met jou linkervoet beweeg. 1, 2, 3, hip. 1, 2, 3, hip. Nou, ek sê nou gent of lady, so dat as julle die step eendag vir 'n man wil leer, dan weet jy wat is lady, wat is gent. Maar vir die solo step, hier is iets wat my maak juk. Vir die solo bachata maak het nie saak wie is gent of lady nie, want jy kan enige oomblik met enige been begin. Ok, so kom ons doen dit gauw gauw weer. Ons gaan een basic side to side doen, en ons gaan dan een basic forward and backwards doen. Hier gaat ons. 1, 2, 3, hip. 1, 2, 3, hip, and forward, and back. Yes, okay. Jolanda, jy mag nie vir my lachie. Okay, so dis jou side-to-side basic, en dis jou forward and backward basic. Nou kry jy wat ons ook noem, jou spot basic. So basis gaan jy net op een plek stilstaan, en jy gaan doen op die plek. Ons doen eers lady, so ons begin met die rechtervoet. 1, 2, 3, hip. 1, 2, 3, hip. Of ons begin as gent links. 1, 2, 3, hip. 1, 2, 3, hip. So dis jou spot basic. Nou voor ons aangaan met die volgende basic wat ek vir julle wil leer, gaan ons eers net gauw bietjie in die tegniek detail ingaan van wat moet jou heupe doen terwyl jy step. Okay, so as jy in die winkelsentrum staan en jy staan in 'n lang ry en wag, dan staan jy nie noodwendig kiers reg op mooi perfek nie. Jy gaan rus gewoonlik op een been en na rukkie dan raak daai been moeg, gaan rus jy op die ander been. So jy rus bietjie op die een been en jy rus bietjie op die ander been. Nou as jy mooi oplet na wat gebeur hier, so is as jy op die been rus, is drie been wat die gewig het, die been se knie is gelok en hierdie heup druk 'n bietjie uit. Waar hierdie been is die losbeen. Oeh, amper val ek om. Ek was te lank laas op my hakke. As jy moeg raak en jy shift jou gewig oor ander kant toe, dan is hierdie heup die een wat uit is, die knie is gelok en die been het al die gewig. En dit, as jy so heen en weer rus op die een heup, rus op die ander heup, dan begin ons te praat van jou Latin hips. En dis wat ons wil hê moet werk terwyl jy besig is met jou bachata. So wat gaan gebeur is, jy gaan nie, excuse, ek wys my ass vir julle. Jy gaan nie soos 'n stokmannetjie kant toe beweeg nie. You see that looks funny. Jy gaan rus and together en rus en tap. Rus and together, rus en tap. Onthou die oomblik as jy tap, moet dit vir jou voel jou bout skrik en dan spring jou heup skielik op. So kom ons doen dit weer. Rus 'n bietjie, ander been, rus 'n bietjie. Skrik. Rus 'n bietjie, ander been, rus 'n bietjie, skrik. En as jy vorentoe en agtertoe beweeg, onthou dis 'n Latin, dan moet jy tone eers dit beweeg. So as jy gaan vorentoe travel, ek draai net dwars dat julle my kan sien, gaan jy nie so met jou hakke loop nie. Jy gaan tone eers loop. So jy imagine daar's 'n R1 noot, R1 muntstuk op die vloer en jy sleep hom onder jou toon soos wat jy loop. En dan bump jy net die heup en nou sleep jy daai R1 muntstuk weer terug soos wat jy agteruit loop. So julle huiswerk vir die res van die week tot en met die volgende klas is vat actually vir jou 'n R1 stuk of 'n 10 sent whatever. Sit dit onder jou tone en dan loop jy so in die huis rond sonder dat jy die 1 sent of die 10 sent mag verloor en oefen om agteruit ook te loop. So julle gaan sien my knie pop, dan lig my hak maar ek sleep my toon op die vloer. En ek pop die knie, lig die hak, en ek sleep die toon op die vloer. So dis jou Latin walk wat jylle bietjie moet oefen. Ok, as ek op die plek bly vir my spot basic, dan sit basis net rus, 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 skrik op die heup, rus, 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 skrik op die heup. So kom ons doen weer 'n komboukie. Ons gaan weer 'n volledige side basic doen, daarna dadelijk 'n volledige forward and backward basic en dan doen ons 'n basic on the spot. Ok, is julle reg? Ek hoop so, hier gaat ons. En, side basic, hip, side basic, hip, dan forward, back, now on the spot, 1, 2, 3, hip, 1, 2, 3, hip, yes! Is julle by? Okay, 100%. Everybody fine? I'm going to do the class in English because Lisa joined us. Okay, the rest of you, everybody is fine with the moves. Okay, let me just get some water. Okay, now, the next basic that we do, it's called corner to corner. So basically, it's a spot basic, but you're going to slightly turn to the one corner and slightly turn to the other corner while you do it. So I'm going to turn my back to you guys again. Let's just do the plain spot basic again, starting with the right foot. 1, 2, 3, hip. 1, 2, 3, hip. Okay, so now we're going to do it again, but we're going to slightly turn to the corner to your right. So we're going to do 1, 2, 3, and then you face the corner when you bump the hip to the front. And now slightly turn to the other side. 1, 2, 3, hip. Let's do it again. 1, 2, 3, hip. 1, 2, 3, hip. Okay, does that make sense? So we're going to put this into a combo again. Now you guys need to focus. We're going to do a side basic. Then we're going to do a spot basic. Then we're going to do a forward and back basic. And then we're going to do the corner to corner basic. Okay, if you get confused, don't worry. We'll just do it again. So let's try. We're starting with the side basic. One, two, three, hip. One, two, three. Now on the spot. One, two, three, hip. One, two, three. Now forward and backwards. One, two, three, hip. One, two, three. Now corner to corner. One, two, three, hip. One, two, three, hip. Let's do that again. And side, side, on the spot. One, two, three, hip. One, two, three. Now forward. One, two, three, hip. Backwards. And now corner to corner. Hip, hip, hey. Okay, now we're going to do the exact same combo again. We're just going to do it a little bit faster. Here we go. Ready? And side. One, two, three, hip. One, two, three, hip. On the spot. One, two, three, hip. One, two. Now forward. And forward. Backwards. Corner to corner. Hip. Let's do the same again. Side, hip, side. On the spot, one, two, three, hip. One, two, forward and backwards. And corner to corner. There we go. Okay, you guys. This is still not the routine, eh? This is just the basic steps we're doing in a little bit of a combo so that you guys can understand it. Okay, now, I don't know if you guys know this. If you don't, I'm just quickly going to explain it. Music works in sets of 8 counts. So usually when you listen to a song, you can count to 8, and then it's as if a new section of the song starts after 8 counts. So usually when we choreograph a dance, we do it in the form of sections of 8. So when we count a move, we will count it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then the next basic is a count of 8 again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Forward and backwards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And corner to corner. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, what can happen is you can change the sideways traveling and even the forward and backward traveling, you can change that into a turn as long as you stick to the exact same counting with your feet. So, it's going to look like this. When I travel to the side, I step side, together, side, and tap. And that's my 4 counts. But now, when I want to change that into a turn, I'm going to do 1, 2, 3, 4. So basically, it's as if your legs open up like this. Keep them open, and then we call this a pivot turn, and turn, and tap. And now you can do exactly the same that way again. So your legs basically stay open. You step, turn, and tap. Let's do that again. We're going to turn. Ready? And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. I hope that made sense. I'm quickly going to do the forward and backward as well. So let's travel directly forward like we did. Right foot first. 1, 2, 3. Tap. But now we're going to turn as we go backwards. 1, 2, 3. Tap. Let's do that again. Going forward with the right foot. 1, 2, 3. Tap. Now turn. 2, 3. Tap. Just don't fall over like I did. Okay. Quickly give me feedback. Can we do the forward with the turn again? Yes, we can definitely do that again. Okay, so going straight forward. 1, 2, 3, Tap. Now my feet are slightly open, so I'm going to keep them open and go in a pivot turn backwards. So I step and I turn, and the last step is going backwards and tap. I'm quickly going to turn to the side with the forward and backwards so that you can see just from another angle. So we're walking straight forward. We're not turning on the traveling forward. One, two, three, four, or hip. Now we go. Turn, turn, back, hip. Let's do that again. Traveling forward, two, three, hip, turn, turn, step back, and hip. Okay, let's see how that went. Sorry. The reason I explained the whole thing of the eight counts is you can change a step as long as you stick to eight counts. So basically, the turn is one variation. So either I can travel sideways, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, or I can turn, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Now I can also change this exact same step to a slide step as long as I stick to the same counts. Then it will look like this. One, two, three, four. Or I can slide to that side. One, two, three, four. So I'm taking out the bunch of steps in between and I'm giving one big step. I'm sliding the leg, and then when I reach count number four, I just bump the hip. So what I want you guys to do with me now, we're going to do a normal side basic that way and back, and then we're going to do the drag step. So here we go. And one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Now drag it. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And I don't know if you ever watched like Fred Astaire movies. There they would do stuff like, ta-da! You have, now we're not going to do the hands, but you want to get the feeling with your body as if somebody wrapped a rope around you and they're pulling you to that side with your hip, and then you bump, and then they pull you that side with your hip, and then you bump. So let's do it again. One normal basic side to side, and then a drag basic side to side. Here we go. And one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Okay. So now I'm going to play music, and I'm going to do it to the music so that you just get an idea of it. But remember what I said, my audio and my visual is not 100% in sync. So for you guys, it might look like I'm going completely offbeat. I promise you, I'm really not. And then also, I cannot talk while I'm playing the music. Otherwise, you won't be able to hear the music at all. So let's see how this goes. Yeesh, I'm bad at English, man. So this is now just the intro. We're going to wait for the beat to start, and then we're just going to do side to side for now. Now let's travel forward and backwards. On the spot. And corner to corner. Oh. Yes, it does make more sense with the music. Okay, so everybody understands it. It makes sense to you guys. Okay, so now, how much time have we got? We've got a bunch of time. Okay, so I want to practice it again to the music. I want you guys to travel along. Even if I'm off rhythm, you guys stick to the rhythm that you're hearing. Don't worry about the arm styling yet. Of course, bachata has actually got a lot of arm styling. The footwork is so easy so that you can focus on the arms that will come later on. So don't worry about too much about that now. For now, I'm just holding my hands here, or you can even hold your hands on your hips, whatever works for you. I will, towards the end of the practice, I will start adding my arms so that you just get an idea of what it will look like. But if it confuses you, don't try to copy me. It's 100% fine. So we're going to do a couple of side basics, a couple of on-the-spot basics, a couple of forward and back basics, and again, a couple of corner-to-corner basics. Okay, here we go. And listen to the music and feel the music. Bachata is really, I know this is going to sound cheesy, but it's a passionate dance, so you guys need to feel the music and enjoy it. Go forward. On the spot. And corner to corner. Okay. Sorry, I actually think I screwed up. I did the one step too early. But you got the idea. Now, again on music, we're going to do the turns. So that you can get the idea of how fast it actually happens. But we're not going to do turns the entire time because you guys are going to get dizzy and fall over. So, for the sake of now, to the music, we're going to do a normal side, one, two, three, hip, and then we're going to turn that way, one, two, three, hip. Then we do a normal side again, and we turn again. Okay, then from there, we're going to do the forward and backwards. With the forward, we're not turning like we practiced previously, going straight forward. But then you turn on the back, going normal forward, and turn on the back. Okay, and then after that, we're going to go, while the music is playing, we're going to go into the slide, or the drag. So then we're going to go through the drag, pop on count four, and drag, and pop on count four. So let's see how that goes.
DJ Kiki.
side. Now you do get bachata music that is slower, but for the purpose of this, we're going to go for the fast because I think you guys can handle it with a little bit of practice. That's why I actually WhatsApped you guys the song so that you can practice to the beat at home up until next time. Okay, we seem to have lost Karen. She was here. She's gone now. I wonder what happened. Anyway, you guys, okay, so we have about 20 minutes left. So I'm going to start with the routine with you guys. Now the routine is basically all the steps we did now combined into a little routine, but then there are little things in between just to spice it up a bit. So, those of you guys who have done crash courses before, like the chair or the pole or the other solo Latins that we did, if you guys remember, it's usually a routine that is choreographed to the entire song. So it's actually a lot of choreography to remember. However, this routine that I did is a short routine that's going to repeat over and over and over again on the song, because it's like a 4-minute song or something. It's quite long. It's 4 minutes, 10 seconds. So this is a short, easy routine. And once you've got the routine, that routine will just keep on repeating throughout the song. However, it's almost like a line dance in the sense that the little routine will turn. So the one moment you'll be facing the one wall and you'll be dancing the entire routine, but then that routine will end facing that wall. Then you dance the entire routine again and it will end facing that wall. So, yes, the routine is not that difficult, but the moment you start changing directions, it can get tricky. Okay, so, but for now, tonight, we're not going to change walls at all. We're going to stick to the same side. So, I'm hot. Let me just get something to cool me down like a fan. Okay, so for now, like I said, I'm turning my back to you guys so you can follow directly. This routine starts with the side basic, like you guys just did now. So you're going to go with the right leg sideways, normal basic. 1, 2, 3, hip. And then we're going to turn to the left. 1, 2, 3, hip. And now we're going to do a drag to the right. 1, 2, 3. But instead of doing a hip, you're going to do a knee lift with a hip. So from the side, it looks like this. So you pick up the toe about towards your knee, and then you still bump the hip up. So let's do that again. To the side. 1, 2, 3, hip, then turn, 2, 3, hip, and slide, 2, 3, hip. Now we do a normal basic to the left. 1, 2, 3, hip. Okay. So it's all steps you've just learned. You've just practiced it. It's just shortly stacked onto each other now. So let's do it again. A normal basic to the right. 1, 2, 3, hip. Then we turn to the left. 1, 2, 3, hip. Then we drag to the right. 1, 2, 3, lift, hold your balance, and now we turn, we travel normal to the left again. 1, 2, 3, hip. Let's do it again, just a little bit faster. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, hip, now turn, 2, 3, hip, and drag, 2, 3, hip, basic, 2, 3, hip. One more time. And 1, 2, 3. Turn. Drag. Basic. Yes. Got it. Perfect. So we're going to do exactly the same. We're just going to speed it up a little bit. Ready? Into position. Here we go. And one, two, three, turn. Drag. Basic. Again. One, two, three, turn. Drag. Basic. Woo! Let's do this to music. Ready? Normal side. Here we go. Now turn. Slide. Basic. Yes. Let's do it again. Just wait for the music. Ready? And. Ah, screwed it up. I'm sorry. Let's do it again. And. Side. Turn. Slide. Let's try it again. Sorry, you guys. One more time. Okay, then we do it one more time. Let's do it one more time without music and a second time again with music. So here we go. Normal side. One, two, three, then turn. One, two, three, then slide. One, two, three, then basic or normal side. Let's just do it again. And one, two, three, turn, slide, side. Okay, you guys will see, even if you decide the entire time for now to keep your hands on your hips, the moment you turn, it's best to take your hands out just to help you a bit with the balance. After that, if you want to keep your hands on your hips again, that's fine. But for the turn, rather take the arms out just to help you a little bit. Okay, let's do that again to music. Let's do it again. And one more time. That was great. Good. Everybody with me. Okay, so like I said, I am recording this entire class. So I'm not sure how I'm going to send it to you guys yet, or maybe I'll just post it on YouTube. I'm not sure. But I am going to send it to you guys so that you can watch it over and over again and practice before next week's class. Okay, next move. Here we go. So now you finished the drag and you did the side with the hip. From here, we're going to do a basic forward with a turn back. So we go forward, one, two, three, hip, and we turn backwards, one, two, three, hip. But now, this is crucial. You guys are going to see I traveled forward. Now, as I'm turning quickly, I have a good look at my body. My posture and everything is currently facing directly forward. As I do the turn, one, two, three, you see what happened to my body. It's as if the momentum of the turn makes me end up facing the corner rather than facing directly forward. I want you guys to do it so that you can get the feeling. So we're traveling directly forward. One, two, three, hip, and then turn, turn, back, hip. So now you'll feel your body is slightly facing towards the left corner, which means you're now already in a corner-to-corner basic. So that's what we're going to continue with now. So we ended up here after the turn, and now we do a corner-to-corner basic. One, two, three, hip. One, two, three, hip. So let's just do that again. We're traveling straight forward, right foot first. One, two, three, hip. Now turn backwards. One, two, three, hip. Then we do corner to corner. One, two, three, hip. One, two, three, hip. So let's put that together from the top. We're going sideways. One, two, three, then turn. One, two, three, then slide. One, two, three, up and side. Now we go straight forward. One, two, three, turn back. And we go corner to corner. One, two, three. One, two, three. Let's stop there. Talk to me. It's okay, as long as you get it. We'll remember now, you guys, what's going to happen is, if all goes well, we're opening on 20 April again, which means by the 22nd of April, is that Wednesday, this specific time slot on the new April schedule will be the Bachata solo class on Wednesday evenings. So even if you're not getting it at the moment, or you're not getting the beauty of it yet, don't worry, we'll fix that once I see you guys face to face. For now, you just need to get the footwork. Okay, remember to mute your mic, Lizelle. Now, we're going to do that exact same bit again, but a little bit faster. So here we go. Ready, set, and one, two, three, hip, turn, slide, travel. Now forward, and one, two, three, then turn, corner to corner, hip, hip. Let's do it again. Oh, and just a random tip. If you guys feel that somewhere suddenly you're on the wrong foot, a golden rule is in dancing is that when you tap, you never put fully weight on that foot. So I'm counting it one, two, three, and then I actually count nothing. That's the tap. But if you tap, make sure there's no weight on that foot. It's just a tap. Let your bum get a scare and then travel again. If you feel suddenly, but now you want to do this, it means that you've put weight on a foot that should only be tapping, and that's why you've got confused with your footwork. Just a random tip. Okay, so let's do this again a little bit faster. And one, two, three, tap, turn, slide, side, forward, turn, corner, to corner. Let's do it again. And tap, tap, lift, tap, tap, tap. Woo! Ooh, I love the bachata. Okay. I'm going to get a sip of water, then we're going to try this to music. Let's just do it again. Ready, and. Okay, let's just do the corner bit again. So in other words, it's after the forward and backwards bit. So we go forward, one, two, three, hip, turn, two, three, hip. So you basically end this turn as if you're already in a corner to corner to the left. And now you still need to do a corner to corner to the right and the left again. So from here we go, on the spot, but look to the right, and then on the spot, but look to the left. So if you're bumping your hip upwards towards the front of you, let's just do that again. We're going to travel straight forward. One, two, three, hip, turn back. Two, three, hip, corner right, and corner left. I've got like 5 minutes, so I'm quickly going to confuse the crap out of you guys. So we ended up like this after that we did the turn backwards. Then we did a corner to that side and a corner to this side. But now, I want you to overturn so that you actually look to the wall, towards your left. In other words, the complete picture is going to look like this. You travel straight forward, then you turn back, slightly looking to the corner on the left. Now you do a corner to corner to the right. So you go one, two, three, hip, looking at the corner. And now you do one, two, three, hip, and you overturn and you look towards the wall. Okay, so we're going to do the entire routine up to there. Traveling to the side. One, two, three, now turn, slide, and side, forward, turn back, corner, and wall, if that makes sense. So you're just turning and you're not stopping at the corner, you're stopping facing a new wall. Okay, quickly tell me if you guys are with me. Perfect. So now we overturned and you guys are looking towards the wall on your left. So technically speaking, you now have to turn your head to the right in order to see me on the screen to know what I'm doing. And your right leg is your free leg, because that's the leg that's tapped. From there, we're going to do a normal back. Okay, so from here, we're going to go. We did the corner, hip, hip, and now we go backwards. One, two, three, but instead, I fall over. Instead of doing a normal hip, you're actually going to flick this foot across. So I'm just going to turn to the front so you guys can see what I'm doing. I'm traveling backwards, one, two, three, and then I'm pointing this toe and I'm crossing it over. So I'm about above my bottom knee or the straight leg's knee. So I'm just, we call this a flick, flicking it up. And then with this foot, sorry, I'm just falling over. With this foot that flicked up, you're going to step a big step forward. And that's all we're going to do for tonight. Okay, so you're facing the wall on your left. You need to turn your head to the right in order to see me. Your right leg is free. We're going to travel backwards. One, two, three, flick, big step. And remember, big step should be with the toe first. So let's just do this from the traveling forward, the original traveling forward, and then the turn backwards. Here we go. Forward, turn back. Corner to corner, but we overturn to the wall. Now travel backwards. One, two, three, flick, big step to the front. Hey, let's do it again. Traveling forward. One, two, three, hip. Turn. One, two, three, hip, corner. Overturn to the wall. Travel back. Flick, step, just up to there. Okay, so we do the corner to corner to the right. One, two, three, corner. One, two, three, wall. So you guys are facing the wall on your original left, and you have to turn your head to the right in order to see me. Your right leg is completely free, And now, remember all the different basics that we practiced. We did the side-to-side basic. We did the forward and backwards basic. So imagine we have traveled forward now, and now we have to finish by traveling back. Back, two, three, and instead of a tap, you're gonna flick it up. Let's just do that again. So from here, travel back with the right foot. Three, two, one. Flick it up and step forward. Did I answer your question? Okay, perfect. So now let's do this slowly from the top. And side, then turn, drag it, side, straight forward, turn back. Corner to the right, and turn to the wall, go back, and flick, step. Let's do it again. And side, tap, turn, tap, drag, lift, basic side, then forward, turn to the back, corner to your right, and wall to your left. Travel backwards, flick your foot across, step forward, and pause. Hit it. Now you're going to hate me, because now we're going to do it to music, and then everybody's going to fall over, including me. Let's see how this goes. I want videos of you guys practicing. You need to WhatsApp it to me. Again. 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 Good. Yay! Woohoo! Okay. So if you guys did it in heels, I hope your feet are hurting like mine at the moment. But it's actually good to be in heels and not just tackies. Or if you're at home, you're probably in pantoffels. Okay, you guys, that was an hour. Well done. I will let you know how I'm going to make plan to send you the video of today. And you've got the song. I've sent it via WhatsApp. So please go and practice it. And if you can, if you want to make WhatsApp videos, you can send it to me. If you're unsure of anything while you're practicing, ask me. I can make short WhatsApp videos to just help you to make sure that you practice it correctly. And then next week, Wednesday, we're going to recap everything up to where we went now. And then I'm going to teach you the last 16 counts. There's only 16 counts left of the routine. And then the routine is done. And then we're going to start practicing dancing the exact same routine on the different walls. So I hope you guys had fun. That was so lekker teaching you guys bachata instead of just something like Zumba or Latinx. So yeah, you guys must have a lovely evening. I love you.